When it comes to Christmas shopping, lots of us leave it to the last minute.
But if you still have shopping to do, there are some crafty ways to make it less stressful.
You've made your list, checked it twice. Time to work out who's naughty and nice. But let's face it, Christmas shopping can be overwhelming. Some people are tricky to buy for. Others, easy. But regardless, there's the problem of budget. So, how do you avoid turning into the Grinch this Christmas?
And for more on this, we're joined by retail expert Juanita Neville-Torito. Nice to see you, Juanita. Christmas shopping can feel a bit overwhelming. Where's the best place to start?
Oh my word, can Christmas shopping feel overwhelming, especially when we've come up the back of Black Friday sales, so you feel like you've really peaked out. Look, you know, where do you start? You've got to make a list. You've got to make a list of who it is you want to buy a present for, set yourself a budget, and set yourself some time, because there's nothing worse than going out into the stores where everyone's just manic with no idea of what you want to do.
And what is the criteria for a great Christmas gift?
Look, I think people get so incredibly stressed about getting the best present and maybe spend a bit more than they need to. The thing is, Christmas is about, you know, sharing with the people you love and letting them know that they matter to you. So gifts should be very thoughtful, they should be personal. There's nothing worse than getting, you know, that soap on a rope that you see sitting, you know, beside the cash register or some hankies. So one of the best places to start is going, having a bit of a think about, you know, what has that person talked about? What do they like? Do they need a treat? And then trying to work your way through defining what sort of gift to get them after that.
Now, some people think that gift vouchers are a little bit impersonal. What's your verdict on them?
Oh my gosh, a gift voucher is one of my favourite gifts to get, because often people want something that might be a little bit beyond your budget, and it gives them the control as well around their present. The other thing too is, if you think that's just like a bit too impersonal from you, is often when you buy a present, ask the retailer, do they actually have something you can give the person with that gift for them to return it? Because you don't want them to have something that can't be returned within a certain period, and often a retailer can print off something that goes with that gift to let them have that flexibility and let the person you're giving the gift to know it's okay if that's not exactly right for them.
And Juanita, can you give us your top ideas for a $10 Secret Santa gift, please?
I would go for, you know, for me with women, a hand cream, and with guys, if you can, maybe a really, really nice craft beer if that's what they like, something they may not have tasted before.
Thank you so much for your time, Juanita. Some great advice there.
Oh, have a wonderful Christmas and thanks.
Well, Jeremy's already got his Christmas gift from me and he loved it. I bought him a goat.
Yep, but I heard that you'd bought me a goat.
Mm.
I was told online that I'd had a goat bought for me, but I haven't seen the goat. When do I get the goat?
No, you don't get the goat. That's the point. I went on to Child Fund, I bought you a goat, you get the e-card, and the goat is in Africa. It goes to the village.
Okay. Do they wrap it? So I'd like them to wrap it nicely. If they're going to wrap it from me...
You can't wrap a goat. No, 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 they give it to the people. It's all good. It's a wonderful gift. I thought you'd be more grateful, quite frankly.